What's going on, all of my healthcare brothers and sisters? I hope that you are having a wonderful day. We are working very hard here at Nurse Cheung to help you pass your NCLEX and your nursing school exams like a boss. We're going to be starting our lab value series, and today we're going to be discussing order of lab draws. Let's get our nurse on. So you might be asking yourself, why is it really particularly important for us to draw our labs in the correct order? Well, really the main reason is because of the preservatives that are found in each specific tube. So preservatives in each tube help with different tests like heparin for clotting, etc., and so on. As we draw our labs, we contaminate the needle each time we insert a lab tube. If one preservative contaminates another tube, we can have skewed results affecting what we do in patient care. So for example, the lavender top tube has a preservative called EDTA. It's an anti-clotting additive. EDTA has lots of calcium. If you collect the lavender tube first, then your green top for calcium, you're going to get an elevated calcium due to this additive. So it's extremely important that these labs are done consistently and in the right order in order to properly treat our patients. So what order do we draw our labs, and what does each tube test for? Well, step one, we always want to draw our blood cultures. Our blood cultures are going to help us diagnose septicemia, toxemia, as well as bacterial cultures when it comes to our sepsis patients. The next one we want to draw is our light blue. That's going to be our coagulation studies, such as our prothrombin times, INR, as well as D-dimers. And in that one, there's an additive called citrate, which is why it's so important that we do these in order. Step three, we're going to go for our red top tubes, and that's going to be our serologies and more complex chemistries, dependent on particularly what the doctor orders. An additive in that is also called clot activator. Step four, we want to use our green top tube. We have biochemistries, a lot of biochemistries done in this, and they have a sodium heparin additive added in this particular tube. Next is going to be our lavender tube. It's always last due to the preservatives that are found in it. Hematology is done with this, all of our like CBCs and additional biochemistries. And that additive, like we talked about before, is EDTA. And lastly, if we need to, we can always draw a gray top tube, and that will be for our lactate. Some organizations will use it for glucose as well as alcohol. And the big mnemonic that we use in order to remember how to draw these labs appropriately is be loving, respectful, gracious, lighthearted, and gentle. Black, blue, red, green, lavender, and gray. I hope that these videos were helpful for you in passing your NCLEX and nursing school exams like a boss. If you haven't done so already, make sure that you subscribe and turn on that notification bell. That way you're informed every time I post a new video here on Nurse Cheung. Make sure you follow me on my social media. I'm on Facebook and Instagram. And check out my website at www.nursecheung.com, where I've posted additional resources such as NCLEX-style questions to help you pass those exams, resources, cheat sheets, and so much more. Until next time, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you all again soon. Bye.